Welcome back, and in this part of the course, you're going to get the experience of working with an existing Docker image. Now, I already have an example containerized application ready to go. And because you're not at the part of the course yet where you're creating your own Docker image, you're going to interact with Docker using an image which I've pre-prepared. And just one important thing before we begin, all of the commands that we use during this demo component of the course are attached to this video. So if you look in the description, you'll be able to see all of the lesson commands that we'll use in this part of the course. Now at this point in the course, you shouldn't have anything running on your Docker host. If you go ahead and open a terminal and then run a Docker space ps, you shouldn't see any running containers. If you do a Docker space images, you should see the Hello World image that you used earlier in the course, and that's okay. I just want to confirm that we've got nothing running on our Docker host which could interfere with this demo component. Now, I haven't gone through the theory of Docker registries yet, but we're going to download a Docker image from the most popular Docker registry, and that's Docker Hub. So I want you to go ahead and open a web browser to hub.docker.com, and then in the Docker Hub search box at the top, I want you to go ahead and search for container of cats. So container of cats, all one word, and press enter. Now you'll probably see a lot of versions of this Dockerized application because students of my other courses have created their own. You're looking for the one that's named acantrol.l/containerofcats. It should be by me, acantrol.l, and right now at the point of creating this video it has over 10,000 downloads. So go ahead and click on this particular Docker image. So this is a Docker image which I've previously created and uploaded to this Docker registry, and it's this image that you're going to interact with for the remainder of this demo component of the course. Now it gives you the Docker pull command to pull this image down to your local machine, so I want you to go ahead and click on this symbol to copy that into your clipboard. And then go ahead and move back to your terminal. Now I'm going to clear the screen to make sure that my terminal is easy to see, and I'm going to go ahead and run the command that I just copied into my clipboard. Now just to step through exactly what this does, it runs a Docker pull, so it pulls an image down from a registry to your local Docker host, and then you include the name of that container image. So in this case it's acantrol.l, which is my Docker Hub username, /containerofcats. So make sure you enter all of that and then press enter. Now this is going to go ahead and download this Docker image. Because we didn't specify a tag or a version to use, it's going to use the default, which is latest. So this means it's going to pull down whichever Docker image I've tagged with latest, and generally this is the latest one that I've pushed into this Docker registry. Now this particular Docker image has multiple file system layers, and you can see that because it pulls each of these here. So each of these is a unique file system layer. And at the bottom you can see that it's downloaded newer image for acantrol.container of cats:latest. So we now have a copy of this Docker image on our local machine. If we run a Docker space images, you'll be able to see that in addition to the Hello World image that you used earlier in the course, you now have a copy of this container of cats Docker image, and it has a unique image ID. Now go ahead and make sure you note that down, because you're going to need that for the remainder of this demo component of the course. Now that we've got that image downloaded, one of the things that we can do is to inspect the image to review the metadata associated with that image, so any information about the image. And we can do that by running a Docker space, inspect space, and then paste in the image ID of the container of cats image, and then press enter. Now as you can see, it outputs a wealth of information about this image. At the top here you can see the full ID, any repo tags, we can scroll down and see when it was created, we can scroll down and see the container config, so various information about the container itself, we can see any labels associated with this Docker image, In my case, the maintainer is Animals for Life, because this is the case study that I use for many of the demo components of my courses. Scroll down further still, we're able to see any volumes, and I'll be talking about volumes later in the course. Likewise, the entry point, this is also something I'll be covering later on in the course. We can see the architecture of the Docker image, the operating system, the size. Scrolling further down, we can see all of the layers which form part of this Docker image. And again, I cover this in detail elsewhere in the course. But at this point, what I want you to do is to run a container using this Docker image. So let's clear the screen to make it easy to see, and let's just run a Docker space images so we've got access to the image ID of this container. Now, in addition to this image ID, we've also got this name, and this can be used instead of this for most commands. So we're going to run a Docker space run space. Now we're going to use a command line option, which I'll be talking about later in the course, and that's hyphen P. Now what we want to do is we want to tell Docker Engine to take port 80 on this container, because this is the port that the application within this container uses, and we want to map port 80 to port 8081 on our Docker host, because that's how we're going to access it. Now don't worry, I'll discuss exactly how this works in detail in the networking part of this course. But just to reiterate, what we're going to use is 8081, and this is the port on our Docker host, so our local machine, that we can use to access this application. And then a colon, and then 80. Now 80 is the port within the container that this application is running on, and hyphen P maps the container port to the Docker host port which we can access. And then we need to put a space and then identify the image that we want to use. And we're going to use a Cantrell with one L / container of cats. Now what we could have done is run this Docker run command without previously pulling the image down to our local machine, and that would have done both of these steps as part of this initial run. So if you run something where you don't have the image locally on your Docker host, it's going to attempt to pull that image down from the registry. Because we've already pulled it, we don't need to do that, and so it can directly run a container from this local image. So we're going to go ahead and do that, so press enter. Now don't worry if you get some slightly different messages as part of this Docker run. Because I'm recording this under macOS, it's giving us a warning that the requested images platform is Linux/AMD64. Now in this case, Docker under macOS is capable of running this image, although it might be a little bit slower. So don't worry if you do see this message or if you don't see it. As long as you aren't returned to the command prompt, so as long as this command is still running, so press enter and you shouldn't see any output, then you're good to go. Now to test out this application, I'll need you to go to a web browser, open a new tab, and type http://localhost:8081. Remember, this is the port on our local Docker host that we're mapping to port 80 on the container. So go ahead and browse to this. What you should see is this containerized application. So this is the container of cats dockerized application. If it fits, I sits in a container, in a container. So this is an application which outputs lots of images of cats in containers running in a container. Now this works okay, so let's go back to our terminal and let's press Control C to return to the terminal prompt. Now if we go back to our web browser and attempt to refresh, this time it's not going to load. Now the reason is because running a command like this attaches our terminal to the Docker container. So if we press Control C to exit out of the command back to our terminal prompt, it actually stops the container running. So if we just delete this and then run a Docker space PS, you'll be able to see that there are no running containers. If we run a Docker space PS space hyphen A and press enter, you'll be able to see that we do have this container, but it's in an exited state. So that's why we're not able to access it. So I'm going to clear the screen. Now what we can do to work around this is to run a Docker space run space hyphen P 8081:80, which is the same command that we previously ran, and then this time space hyphen D, and this will detach our terminal from this container. We'll still need to specify the image that we want to use, so acantrol/containerofcats, and then press enter. Now this time it's going to take us back to our terminal, only this time the Docker container will still be running. So if you run a Docker space PS, you'll be able to see that the container is currently running. It's up for 14 seconds. If we go back to our web browser and refresh, you'll see that it loads the containerized application. Now generally when you run containers, you are going to run them in detach mode, so you don't need to keep the terminal open. But I just wanted to illustrate the difference between both of those modes. So I'm going to clear the screen to make it easy to see, and then run a Docker space PS. Now what I want you to do is to copy down this container ID into your clipboard. The next command we're going to run is docker space port and then the container ID and press enter. And this is going to tell you the port mapping configuration of this running container. So on the left here we have the port that's used within the running container, and then on the right we can see how this is mapped onto the Docker host. So it's mapped onto any IP address on the Docker host and then port 8081. Now because our container's running, we can actually run commands within the container. So we can use docker space exec, and this allows us to execute a command within the container, then hyphen it, and then we need to paste in the container ID, and then a space, and then we can type the command that we want to run. So let's say we want to list all of the processes running within this Docker container. Well, we can run ps space hyphen AUX, and this will do a full process listing of anything inside this container. So go ahead and press enter, and you'll see all of the processes running within this container. And what you should see is this process, which is the Apache web server. Now again, don't worry if yours looks slightly different. For example, if you don't see this, this is dependent somewhat on what architecture you're running the container on. In this case, I'm using macOS, and so you see this. What's important from your perspective is that you can see that it's running the Apache web server inside this container, so it's only running Apache. So earlier in the course when I mentioned that Docker containers are really good for running single processes inside a container, this is what I mean. So the first process, so process ID or PID 1, is the Apache web server, and then any of these are child processes of Apache. So all this container's running is our single web application. Now I'm going to clear the screen to make it easier to see, and then just run a Docker PS so we have access to the container ID. We could do something a little bit more complex with the exec command. So docker space exec, and then a space, hyphen IT, then this container ID, and then a space, and then sh. And what this will do is run a shell inside the Docker container and connect us to that shell. So press enter, and we're now inside the Docker container. So if I run a ps space hyphen aux, we'll see the same output. So I'm currently running commands inside a shell inside the Docker container. If I run a df space hyphen k and press enter, here we can see the file system inside the Docker container. And I'll be talking more about Docker storage elsewhere in the course. For now, I'm going to type exit to exit out of this shell. Clear the screen to make it easier to see. And then run a docker space ps again. Now we can interact with containers directly, so we can run a docker restart and then a container ID to restart the container. Likewise, we can run a docker space stop and then the container ID to stop this container. Now if we run a docker ps, we'll see no running container. If we run a docker space ps space hyphen a and press enter, we can see that we now have two stopped containers. We can run a docker space start and then paste in the container ID and press enter, and that will start up the container again, and we could run a docker space ps to verify that it's started and currently running. And we can see in the status column that it's up for 5 seconds. So those are just some ways that you can interact directly with a container. I'm going to clear the screen to make it easy to see, and then run a docker space ps again. We can gain access to logging information for this container. By running a Docker space logs space, and then the container ID. And this will show us any logs for this container. We can show the timestamp by running the same command but hyphen T at the end. Now this is useful if you want to perform simple diagnostics with a container. Now that's everything I wanted to cover in this demo part of the course. I just wanted to give you some experience of basic interaction with an existing Docker image, specifically using it to run up a container and interact with that container. At this point, all we need to do is clean up everything that we've created within this demo component. So I'll type clear to clear the screen and then run a Docker space PS. First, I'm going to stop this container. So Docker space stop space and then the container ID. Then I'm going to remove this container to keep things tidy. So Docker space RM space and then the container ID. Clear the screen again. Now, if I run a Docker space PS, we'll see no running containers. If I run a Docker space PS space hyphen A, we can see an old version of this container of cat's container. So I'm going to select this container ID and run a Docker space RM and paste this in and press enter. And that just makes sure I've cleared up all of the old container of cat's containers. Clear the screen. Next, run Docker space images, and this will list all of the images that we've got stored locally. Then I'm going to run a Docker space RMI for remove images. Copy down the image ID of the container of cat's image and paste that in and press enter. And that's going to delete the image and any of the file system layers that are not used by any other images. And at this point, you've done everything needed in this demo part of the course. So you've downloaded a pre-existing Docker image, you've used it to spin up a containerized application, and you've interacted with that application, as well as performing some diagnostic steps by entering a container shell, interacting with that container, and viewing the logs of that container from the Docker host. But at this point, that's everything in this part of the course. When you're ready, go ahead and move on to the next part of this course.